Hi, and welcome to another Fuseday video. Did you see all the cool stuff that's now in Resolve 19? I'm sure you have. The newest beta even has additional guides in the viewer, and they look very professional. But did you see what was not in Resolve 19? A way to snap to these guides or even change them on the fly, something that people have been asking for quite a while now. People want custom grids, custom guides that can be used to align elements to each other. But don't worry, I've got you covered. I've spent the last couple of weeks figuring out how to build a macro to do this straight from the edit page, and I think I've cracked it. Today I'm launching SDR Grids and Guides, a completely customizable solution to create snappable grids with merges with extra guidelines to help you line up all of your logos and footage. It supports up to 8 layers that can be dragged and dropped straight from the edit page's timeline. I've been working on this in the beta release of Resolve 19 to make sure that this tool works with this new version. But there are some glitches in Resolve to take into account when working with this new tool. I will cover this during the walkthrough, but first hit like, subscribe and click on the bell icon. Ready? Then let the walkthrough begin. SDR Grids and Guides comes in two flavors, one generator and two effect versions. After installing, you will find them in the submenu SDR called Grids and Guides, Grids and Guides Pro and Single Grid and Guide. They all have a lot in common and they have some differences, but I'll start with the generator one because that's the most user-friendly version. You will be greeted with this default view. The settings are pretty much self-explanatory, but I'll go through them anyway. We have the show grid option, which shows or hides the grid. You have the grid over under option in case you want to have the grid on top or below the items that you're aligning to each other. The horizontal subdivisions and the vertical subdivisions also speak for themselves. If you want to have a nice rule of third grid, you just enter 3 and 3 and you have a nice grid like that. Or if you want to be sure that you center everything, you can just make everything in even numbers and everything will be centered. To fine tune your settings, you can use the grid offset X and Y to offset the grid in X and Y. Grid lines thickness decides how thick they are, and the grid opacity lets you fade the grid in and out. Use the color to change the grid color, and that's basically everything there is to know about grids and guides grid settings. Now let's start lining out some objects. Say we have a couple of logos, Fusion, DaVinci, my own logo, Gumroad. Now to get objects into the scene, all you have to do is drag and drop from the media pool into the clip value fields here over on the right. So since this is my macro, we'll start with my logo, Shadow Maker SDR. Look at that, isn't it nice? It's a macro for Resolve. And you can also use it with Fusion, and it will be available on Gumroad in my coffee page. So now I have 5 clips that I want to line out to each other. So we'll start with the top one. Let's make it a bit smaller, and I want to snap it to the grid. And every layer comes with its own guide. So I have 5 items and I want to put them here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on top of each other. I'll put the gumroad right there. And this is one of the cases where it might be nicer to have the grid underneath the items we're trying to align. So I'll switch to grid under. I'll size down the Fusion logo by a lot, say like so. I'll snap that one to the grid as well. Same goes for the DaVinci Resolve logo. I'll snap that to the grid so. And as the final thing, I'll put my own logo also on the grid like so. You can turn off the guides to get a better look at what you're doing. I can hide the grid like this. And I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 items lined up pretty neatly. Now, because they're aligned to the grid, they're also influenced by the grid offset options. So if I move the grid offset like this, I can move all items at the same time. And of course, it works vertically as well. Personally, I like it better if they're left aligned. So every clip has its own slider to line everything out. And to get a better view of the final result, you can also turn off the fusion overlay, and this is what you get. And because of the fact that it's grid-based, you can also align things in a slightly different way. Now they're all lined up like this, but I think it would be nicer if they're all aligned at the bottom. So they all line up. Like so. As I mentioned earlier, this version is the most user-friendly, but also the least flexible one, because it only works with clips that are available in the media pool. And this means that you can use a video of Charlie, like this. And you can set its start frame so it doesn't start at the beginning, but it doesn't work with things like titles because they don't exist in the media pool. Even if I put them in the media pool like this, Resolve doesn't accept them as media ins. What you can do, but this is a kind of a workaround, you can turn it into a compound clip. And as soon as it becomes a compound clip, you can import it from the media pool. But because of the fact that it's a compound clip, it's not as easy to edit, because then I have to open it in a timeline, make a different title, close my timeline, and then it's back. But there's a different way to deal with that. There's also a fusion effect version that only works on one element at a time, and which is called single grid and guide, because that's what makes sense. Just drag and drop the effect on your logo or whatever in your timeline, and you get access to the same grids, helplines, and alignment functions as the generator one, but it only supports that one clip. Now, if you want to work with multiple items, you can give each of them a fusion effect like this, and as long as the grid and snap settings are the same, the alignment will still work, but it's not as elaborate as the generator version. What's also great about the single grid and guide is that it works with titles and other stuff. So there's no need for compound clips, because you can just have this nice clean and simple sample text, put the grid and guide on top of it, and you'll see that it looks like shit. And this is because the effect is set up to automatically center whatever it is that's coming into the picture based on its domain of definition. But since this title is changing its size and therefore its domain of definition, the tool gets mixed up. To deal with it, I have an expert button which turns off the auto domain clip. And as soon as you turn that off, you get a nice and clean sample text which you can still resize and reposition. So say you want the left corner to be here in the left corner, I can change the alignment horizontally and vertically to here, and then just use the guide to line it up like so. And I can even resize it again so it fits nicely into the square. Or if I want to, I can also put it over the square and resize it even further, like this. And you get a nice, clean and simple sample text aligned to the square. Now for the final iteration of this tool, Grids and Guides Pro, things are slightly different. On background clip, you start with an adjustment clip, use Grids and Guides Pro on top of it, and then you can do the rest of your work in the Fusion page. The generator version comes with built-in media in nodes, which is great for drag and drop functionality, but it's less flexible. So in this case, you can still drag from the media in pool, hold Alt to select which clip you want to use, and the rest of the settings are all the same as in the generator version. But what's different is that since this is in Fusion, we can now change this. So if I want to make this the logo, the DaVinci logo, black and white, I can do that. And if I go back to the edit page, there it is in black and white, and I can move it from the edit page. So all the alignment options are the same, but it's much more flexible, which means that you can also have things like titles in here. Say I have a clean and simple lower third like this. I can go into the Fusion page, copy that, go into my adjustment clip, and use the clean and simple as an input. The generator version comes with built-in media ins, which is great, but is kind of limiting if you want to do something yourself. Say you want to make some bullet points, you would have to convert them into image clips first and then import them in the media pool, and then you can align them. But if you use the Grids and Guides Pro version, you can create, say, a nice button like this, and then just drag it into clip 1, drag it in clip 2, clip 3, and clip 4, etc., etc. And then you can just use the snap to grid options to put them where you want them. Just snap it to the grid, and we have 4 bullet points nicely aligned to each other. Now, if this was the generator version and you would want to change everything that's in there, you would have to go back into the media pool, drag into new stuff, and etc., etc. But now you can just put a merge after this and say you have a nice red line like so. You can move it like this. And of course, you want to have everything left aligned, and it looks very nice. So this gives you much more flexibility than the generator version, but it does take more work. So you have to be a pro to use it. So that's why it's called Grids and Guides Pro. And of course, as you expect from macros like these, everything can be animated as well. Now here is where the downside that I talked earlier about rears its ugly head. Since I'm doing this in the public beta of Resolve 19, there are some glitches that still need to be worked out. For example, if I animate horizontal alignment, you get extra controls that you shouldn't be using because they mess up the rest of the tool. Resolve should hide these things because they are supposed to be hidden, but in the current version it still shows them. I just hope it gets fixed shortly. So this is SDR Grids and Guides. I think it's a worthwhile addition to every editor's toolset. It covers almost all of the features that were requested on the Blackmagic Design Forum. Custom grids, snapping, alignment, everything is there. For the last couple of years, I've been sharing most of my tutorials and macros for free with the Fusion and Resolve community, but this macro has taken so much effort that I'm making it a paid download. Based on the amount of requests for this feature, I'm pretty sure it fulfills a need for a lot of people. And since it will save people time, it will also save people money, so I think it's worth the price I'm setting here. You can get this macro for $15, or with a special offer you can also get it for $10, but stay tuned for that. I don't know where Resolve users like to go to buy presets and plugins, so for now I'm just hosting on my Ko-fi page and my Gumroad. If you have a marketplace that you prefer to these, let me know in the comments below and I'll see if I can add it to those as well. Now, I just said you can also get this macro for $10, and this is how to do it. I couldn't have made this macro without the continuing support of the Fusion community at the We Suck Less forum over at www.stakeunderwater.com. The bigger this community gets, the better it is for all Resolve and Fusion users as a whole. So I'm giving away a $6 discount for people who join the paid We Suck Less Patreon at any tier. If you do, you will get access to a locked post where you can find a $6 discount code for $6. Now, if you apply this code at checkout time, this macro will only cost you $9. So if you join We Suck Less at the lowest tier, the total price will come to $10 in total. A sweet deal, and you'll help support a great resource for all things Fusion. So that's it for me for today. I hope this video was useful, and I'll gladly see you all next Fuseday. Let's keep that fuse burning.